Good morning, students. In continuation of IUPAC nomenclature, these are the IUPAC nomenclature of so many organic molecules. After that, I explained rules. Okay, listen that video at least nearly 4 to 5 times. Then only you will get some phenomenon of some knowledge on how to write the name of an organic molecule. Okay, here after that rules, I will give you some examples. I will give hundreds of examples. In continuation, we will discuss all those examples. Before that, in NEET point of view or in CET point of view or any point of JEE point of view, they may give one bond line structure. Write the IUPAC name of that bond line structure. We don't know about how to write the bond line structure. Here I will give how to write the bond line structure and what is the complete structure of an organic molecule, how to write the condensed structure of an organic molecule. And here I am taking one chemical formula. By taking that, I will write all those structures. First organic molecule, I start with this one. Molecular formula. Here I am taking molecular formula of molecule. Here I am writing condensed structure. Here I am writing complete structure. After this, here I am writing bond line structure. Simple first molecule. Here I am taking molecular formula of compound, that is first molecule methyl. First I am writing name. After that we see methyl. Condensed structure of methane also same CH4. Complete structure of methane. Complete means you put the carbon. The carbon valency is 4. That means carbon forms 4 bonds around it. I put here 4 bonds. How many hydrogens are there? Here hydrogen. This we call as complete structure of methane. There is no bond line structure for methyl. Bond line means we should need two atoms, at least two carbon atoms. So methane has only one carbon atom, so no bond line structure for that. Then in continuation, we'll see the second molecule. Here C2H6. The common name of this molecule, or IUPAC name of this molecule, is ethane. Don't think about name of molecule. First, how to write the bond line. Condensed structure means here I am writing CH3. This is the condensed structure of ethane. C2H6 can be divided into CH3. This is the condensed structure. Complete structure means carbon and carbon here, right? Carbon bond. And here one hydrogen. This is the complete structure of ethane. Here bond line structure. In bond line structure, never mention carbon atom, never mention hydrogen atom. But we mention different atoms. We mentioned oxygen, we mentioned nitrogen, we mentioned sulfur or any atom, except carbon and hydrogen. How will represent here? With only bond. Here dot. Just put the dot and here put the like this, straight line. This dot indicates one carbon atom. This also indicates carbon atom. This indicates carbon atom. This one carbon indicates carbon atom. End of this one also indicates with carbon atom. Here we don't show the hydrogen atoms. Now how we know how many hydrogens are there like that? How many hydrogens are present here? How we know that one? Here carbon forms one bond now. Remaining hydrogens. What is the valency of carbon? 4. Here this is the carbon. It forms one bond with the another carbon. This carbon also forms one bond with the this carbon. One formula remaining. How many bonds we require? 3 bonds required. So this carbon contain 3 hydrogens. This carbon contain 3 hydrogens. Okay, it has 3 hydrogens. Here also it has 3 hydrogens. Both carbon atoms are having 3 each hydrogens. We represent like that only. Okay, in continuation we see some more molecules. Okay, here I am taking one molecule C3H8. What is the C3H8? Propane. This is the propane. What is the meaning of propane? What is the condensed structure of propane? CH3, CH2, CH3. Complete structure of propane here. CH3 na, right here 3 hydrogens. Here CH2 na, right 2 hydrogens. Here CH3 na, right 3 hydrogens. It is a complete structure of propane. How to write the bond line structure? Here, one dot. Dot means one corner, one carbon. Then, write like this. One carbon atom, central carbon atom. Here, one carbon atom. See here, it contains how many hydrogens? It forms only one bond. It contains 3 hydrogens. It also forms one bond. Here we have 3 hydrogens. This central carbon forms one bond, one bond. 1 plus 1, 2 bonds. That means it contains 2 hydrogens. Okay, this we call as bond line structure of propane. Bond line structure of propane. Okay, here in continuation we see the C4H10. C4H10. The name of this molecule is butane. What is the condensed structure of this one? CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. This is the condensed structure. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. And here, complete structure means, write like this. Hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. Complete structure of butane. Then, here, bond line structure means, here bond, one carbon, two carbons, three carbons, four carbons. This is only bond line. Okay, this forms one bond with carbon. So, this carbon has three hydrogens. This carbon forms two bonds with the two carbons. So, it has, it has two hydrogens. Here also two hydrogens. Here also three hydrogens. This is the bond line structure of, bond line structure of butane. Here I am taking one last simple one, C5H2. Pentane. Here, what is the condensed structure of pentane? CH2CH3. CH3, first start with CH3, end with CH3. In between that, you write CH2CH2CH2. Why? It forms two bonds now, that's why you wrote CH2. Then, complete structure common. H3 na? H here, H here, H, H, C, H, H, H. Okay, and here, bond line structure. Bond line structure, how many carbons are there? 5 carbons. Start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the bond line structure of pentane. Bond line structure of pentane. Visible other than?
Yes.
Then, in continuation, you will see the some more molecules. here we are not taking molecular formula, just I am taking 2-methyl pentane, cyclic keep. Okay, continuation up to here only. See, please. Here only.
Yes, sir.
Huh? Okay. 2-methyl pentane. 2-methyl pentane means, okay, here structure is CH3, CH3, HCH2, CH2, CH3. This is the 2-methyl pentane. Okay, and here this is the condensed structure of 2-methyl pentane. Here I am writing a condensed position. CH3, CH, CH2, CH2, CH3. This is 2-methyl pentane. Why this is 2-methyl pentane? Here I am writing, giving number A. From left to right or right to left? Left to right. Why? Okay, lowest number in two. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. According to the lowest number, this substance containing carbon should get the lowest number. Should get the lowest number. When we give numbering from left to right, this substance carbon gets the second position. If you give right to left, this carbon gets fourth position. Okay, 2 is the less number, that's why we are using this one. Okay, 2-methyl pentane. Complete structure means, okay, how to write the complete structure? C, write all hydrogens here. C, H, H means downside, we write hydrogen. Hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. Here also, hydrogen, hydrogen. Here also, hydrogen, hydrogen. Here, C, H, H, H. You write like this only. Complete structure means should represent the hydrogen along with the carbon. Okay, next time, okay, I won't write this complete structure. Okay, bond line structure. Bond line structure means how many carbons are present here? 5 carbons. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Finish now? Here 5 carbons are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then give the number. Okay, left to right or right to left? 1, 2, 3, 4. At second position, what we have? Methyl. Methyl means you put like this only. Put like this only. Don't write the hydrogens. This is the bond line structure of 2-methyl pentane. 2-methyl pentane. Here I am taking one more molecule. 2, 3, 4. Trimethyl pentane. Just I am writing only condensed structure. Okay, I don't write complete structure. Complete structure means you write like this one. Okay, so very easy. CH3, CH, CH3, CH, CH3, CH, CH3, CH3. Okay, give the numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's second position, third position, fourth position. We have the 3 methyls, that's why I mentioned 2, 3, 4, tri. Okay, 3 methyls are there, so I use tri-pentane. Tri-methyl pentane. Okay, write bond line structure. Okay, just you write, yeah, right means, okay, write all hydrogens, all carbons like that, like this only. We'll get bond line structure. We'll get complete structure. How to write bond line structure? First, write pentane. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Give the number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. At second position, what we have? Methyl. At fourth position, third position, what we have? Methyl. At fourth position, what we have? Methyl. Okay now. Methyl. This is the bond line structure of 2, 3, 4 trimethyl pentane. 2, 3, 4 trimethyl pentane. Then in continuation, we'll see the 2-methyl टू मिथाइल फोर इथाइल ऑक्टेन, फोर इथाइल ऑक्टेन। ऑक्टेन मीन्स हाउ मेनी कार्बन एटम्स, एट कार्बन एटम्स। ओके फर्स्ट आई एम राइटिंग टू मिथाइल फोर इथाइल सी एच थ्री, हियर सी एच थ्री एच सी एच टू सी एच, हियर इथाइल सी टू एच एंड हियर सी एच टू सी एच टू सी एच टू सी एच थ्री, एट कार्बन। ओके हाउ टू राइट द इथाइल ग्रुप, फॉर दैट ओनली आई टुक इथाइल, फॉर दैट ओनली आई टुक इथाइल। ओके हियर how to write the bond line structure, first eight carbon atoms, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, give the number 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, at second question what we have with right isosteres, at fourth question ethyl is there, how to write the ethyl, here write like this then like. What is the meaning of this? This is the CH2, this is the CH3. Okay, this is the bond line structure of this molecule. Okay, how to write the bond line structure of alkene? Alkene means here I am taking 1-butene. 1-butene. Butene means, but means 4 carbon atoms. 4 carbon atoms. E means double carbon. Okay, one means double bonded first carbon, CH2, CH, CH2, CH3. This we call 1-butene. Why put here I see CH? Already carbon bond, 3 bonds here, 1 bond here. 2 bonds here, 1 bond here. 2 plus 1, 3 bonds finish. 3 bonds finish. We require only 1 bond. So, I put here hydrogen. Here I why here put 3, here put 2 means here single bond is there, here double bond is there. Double bond means 2 bonds finished. We need 2 more bonds. So I put H2. I put here H2. Okay. How to write bond line structure? How many carbons are there? 4 carbons. Write first 4 carbon atom. 1, 2, 3. Finish it now. Next, double bond is presented. Give the name. Double bond is presented first carbon. So, write like this. This is the bond line structure of 2-butene. Bond line structure of 2-butene. Okay, in continuation. Okay, 2. Sorry, bond line structure of 1-butene. Sorry. Okay, here in continuation, we will see the 2-methyl, 2-butene. 2-methyl 2-butene. See, simple molecule. First I took simple molecule. Continuous. Okay, complexity increasing. Okay, in continuation, we have more and more like that. Okay, 2-methyl 2-butene. First write 2-butene means CH3, CH double bond. Okay, here. CH, CH. This is 2-butene. Okay, here. Methyl. This is the structure of 2-methyl 2-butene. 2-methyl 2-butene. Okay, just don't think about IUPAC. I will give so many examples in continuation. We discuss. Just what we are discussing here, how to write the bond line structure. How to write the bond line structure only. Okay, here 1, 2, 3, 4. Write 4 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. Finish now. At second carbon, this is the second carbon, we have the double bond. And here we have the methyl. Methyl group means you mention like this. This is 2-methyl 2-butene. 2-methyl 2-butene. Okay, for example, propyl is there. Propyl. Just I am giving one only. Propyl. That is like, oh, you see. I have a limit. Okay, here I am taking propyl. Propyl means how many molecules? So how many carbons present in propyl?
Three.
Okay, three carbons with the triple bond. With triple bond. Yes, na? Propyl means okay. Propyl. Here I am taking propyl. Propyl CH3 C triple bond CH. This is the condensed structure. Okay, here how to write the bond line structure? Three are there, na? One, two, three. Finish, na? At this position we have triple bond. So write triple bond. So write triple bond. This is the structure of propyl. Suppose for example, okay, I am taking one molecule CH3 Cl Cl CH3 CH3. Okay, here Br F CH2OH. CH2OH. Okay, here how many carbon atoms? Okay, we just remember first carbon atoms. Okay, how many carbon atoms are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Straight carbonous carbon. Write 5 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Finish. Okay, after writing the longest carbon chain, give the number. Okay, here this starting with the first carbon has what we have here? OH. Write OH as this. Okay, after that CH2 is there. This is the CH2. Then here we have fluorine and bromine. Yes, na? Fluorine and bromine. Here what we have? 2 methyls. Don't write carbon and hydrogen. I wrote here bromine, fluorine, OH. Okay, here chlorine. This is the bond line structure of this molecule. Okay, instead of that, this you write upside OH for our convenient. Okay, in continuation, you take any molecule like this CH3, C double bond O, CH3 is the. Okay, the common name of this molecule is acetone. Common name of this molecule is acetone. Okay, how to write the bond line structure? Here methyl, here double bond, here. Okay, now here methyl, double bond. This is the structure, bond line structure of this. Okay, propanaldehyde. Here I am taking one more propanaldehyde. CH3, CH2, C double bond O, H. C double bond O, H. Propanaldehyde. The common name of this one is propanaldehyde. Propanaldehyde. Okay, here. Carbon. Here carbon. Carbon, carbon, carbon. Here we have the double bond. And here, if you mention it like this, here also we carbon. If you write like this, here also we expect carbon. But what we have here? Hydrogen. So write hydrogen. Here carbon is there, so I write it. Here hydrogen is there, I wrote hydrogen. If hydrogen is there, we call aldehyde. If only carbon is there, we call T2. We call S2, T2, like that. Okay, for example, CH3, okay, here CH3 is here. The name of this molecule is isobutane. Isobutane. Why we call this one isobutane? Present in Y shape. Okay, right? IUPAC, sorry, bond line structure of isobutane. Okay, here carbon, here carbon, carbon. Like this. Then sleeping version. This is the bond line structure of isobutane. Bond line structure of isobutane. Here I am taking neopentane. Neopentane. The molecular formula of neopentane is C5H2N. C5H2N. The structure is CH3, C CH3. This is the structure of neopentane. Bond-like structure of neopentane is X. Here carbon. This is the methyl. This is the methyl. This is the methyl. This is the methyl. This is the bond-like structure of neopentane. Bond-like structure of neopentane. Okay, any molecule. Okay, write like this. Don't write the carbon. Don't write the hydrogen. Except the right thing. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the some more molecules. Okay, CH2 double bond CH. Okay, CH3 H C C2 H5 H. Okay, C double bond O CH2. Okay, C H here B R C O O H. This is the one molecule. Don't think about big molecule or small molecule. Just follow the rule. How many carbon atoms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the function. Write this one as this. Okay? Write that one as this or will like this may be written like this also. C double bond O OH. Okay, here first I am writing only bond line. How many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Write 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Finish now. This first carbon, C double bond O is there. And here, OH is there. Okay now. After that carbon, here what we have? Br is there. Then CH left. Here C double bond O is there. C double bond O. Then here C2H5 is there. C2H5 means bond like this. Then CH3 is there. Then here double bond is there. This is the bond line structure of that molecule. Bond line structure of that molecule. Okay, with the so many complications. See, CH2. Double bond C, CH3. Okay, here C, CH3. And here C double bond O, C, NH2. And here OH. And here C, triple bond C, CH2. Okay, C double bond O, H. C level bond O H. So many groups are there. Right? How many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 carbons. Right? 9 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Finish now. Last carbon. Double bond. Should write H. Next year, CH2. Then here, what we have? Triple bond here. Triple bond here. After the triple bond, upside, OH is there. Downside, NH is there. Okay, otherwise you write both sides there. Here you write NH to OH like this. That is also same. After that, here this carbon, C double bond O is there. Here, methyl. Methyl. This OH and H2 also write like this. Two methyls are here. One methyl. And here?
Double bond.
Okay, this is about the just bond line structure. Bond line structure, complete structure and condensed structure of an organic molecule. Then in continuation, we will see the IUPAC nomenclature. How to write the IUPAC name? how to write the IUPAC name of an organic molecule. First, okay, I am giving simple molecules. What is the principle? First, prefix. Okay, then root word, primary suffix and secondary suffix. Before writing the name of any organic molecule, IUPAC name of organic molecule, you should know about the complete information about, okay, you should know about the complete information about four words. What are those? One is prefix, second one is root word, third one is primary suffix, second one is fourth one is secondary suffix. Should know about that. Without information of those groups or those words, we can't write the IUPAC nomenclature of IUPAC name of any organic molecule. We can't write the IUPAC name of any organic molecule. Okay, just here I am taking some molecules. Okay, I will write names of organic molecule. First I am taking one molecule, CH3CH2OH, or first instead of OH I am taking chlorine. First you find any substance are there. Substance is nothing but prefix. Any substance are there here substance is there. What is that substance? Chlorine is substance. Chlorine is substance. Substance is nothing but prefix. Substance is nothing but prefix. So write here prefix. If chlorine is present in organic molecule, we use prefix as a chloro. After the chloro, after the substance, what we write here? What we write here? Root word. Root word means number of carbon atoms present in a organic molecule. Okay, number of carbon atoms present in a longest carbon chain. Here, how many carbon atoms are present? How many? Two carbon atoms present. Two carbon atoms means write it. If two carbon atoms present in organic molecule, what we write? What we use? Root word it. One is there, with two are there means it, prop, but, pent, exit, et, like. We mention like. Okay, chloro, it. Is there any double bond or triple bond? No. Double bond is there, we use E. Triple bond is there, we use I. Okay, single bond is present, we use A. Okay, write A. The IUPAC name of this molecule is chloroethane. The IUPAC name of this molecule is chloroethane. Okay, suppose for example, I am taking one more molecule, same type of molecule, CH2NO2. NO2 group, it is also one of the substance, prefix. NO2 means nitro. NO2, if NO2 present in substance in organic molecule, we use nitro as a prefix. Okay, first write prefix nitro. Okay, now nitro. How many carbons are there? Two carbons. It nitro. Nitro. Okay, then CH3. CH2OH. Here OH is functional group and substrate. Actually OH appeared as a functional group and substrate. These both are chlorine and nitro groups are only substrates. But OH appeared as a substance and functional group. Is there any substance except OH? No substance. No substance are present in this molecule, so OH acts like a functional. If substances are there, if substances are there, okay, little bit difficult. We'll continue, we'll see in continuation that one also. Okay, here there is no substance, so it acts as a functional group. It acts as a functional group. If substances are there, substance, methyl substance is there, then it acts as a functional group. Okay, another group, for example, aldehyde functional group is there, then it acts as a substrate. Okay, yesterday I gave one preference order. How will write the preference? How will give the preference? How will give the numbering to that molecule? Okay, here functional group is here. Okay, here it is not prefix. Remember this. OH is not here prefix. When it becomes prefix, if aldehyde or carboxylic acid, ester or any functional carbon functional group is there, it becomes prefix. Otherwise, it is functional. Okay, here, how many carbons are there? Two carbons. Okay, no prefix now. So, write first, if, okay, N, and here, it is a functional group, secondary suffix. Secondary suffix means, if secondary suffix present as a OH, we use the OL, OL. We use the OL, OL. What happened here? Okay, what the name of complete, by writing complete name, remove E. It, N, O. Ethanol. The name of the molecule is ethanol. Okay? Then, CH3, CHO is there. CHO also functional group. It also acts as functional group substrate. Okay, here we have single group, so it acts as a functional group. It acts as a functional group. What is the IUPAC name? How many carbons are there? Two carbons. So, it. No double bond, no triple bond. Eight. And if CHO functional group is present in organic molecule, we use secondary suffix as ALR. Ethanol. This is the ethanol, this is the ethanol. Remember that. Okay, for example, CH3, CH2, OH. See, complexity increasing. CH3, CH, CH3, CH2, OH. What is the methyl group? Substituent. What is the OH group? Functional group. Already I said in rule, substituent and functional group is there means you give the more preference to functional group. Then give the preference to substituent. Give the numbering from left to right, right to left. Which is less toward the functional group? That only we follow. That says lowest numbering. Here, while giving left to right, right to left, of OH group attached carbon gets first position. OH group attached carbon gets first position. Left to right, third position. So, one is less or three is less? One is less. Lowest number. So, you follow this rule. You don't follow this rule. That means you give the first position to OH group. Why? It is a functional group. It is a functional group. Okay, what? Just write. First, by writing the IUPAC name, first we write the prefix. Which are prefixes are, which prefixes are present here? Methyl prefix is there. At which position? 1, 2, second position. Right. Okay, put the dash. Which prefix this one? What is the name of this one? Methyl. Methyl. Comma. Then, after the prefix, in principle what we have? Root word. How many carbons are present here?
Three.
three carbons. So three carbons present means what we use?
Propane.
Any double bond is there? No. No means primary suffix. Ane. Propane. Don't write E. We'll remove that one. OH group is there. If OH group is present, what we use? OL. 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 2-methyl propanol. The IUPAC name of that molecule is 2-methyl propanol. Okay, we are writing like this IUPAC nomenclature. Okay, IUPAC nomenclature of molecule. Okay, in continuation, we will see the some of molecules. Okay, here CH3COOH. CH3COOH. Okay, here it contains only functional group, no substance. COOH is the first priority functional group. No other molecules. No more other groups are any. So, right here, first. How many carbon present? 2 carbon. It. No double bond, no triple bond between carbon. Ane. If COOH group is present in organic molecule as a functional group, we use secondary suffix as oic acid. Oic acid. It. Ane plus oic acid. Ane plus oic acid. By writing complete name, remove the E. Ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid. Suppose for example, here CH3CHClCOOH. Here, chlorine is substandard. COOH is functional. We should do the more preference to the functional. Okay, give the numbering from this side. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, here first, what we write here? Prefix. What is the prefix here? Chlorine is prefix. You write like this, prefix. A substrate. At which position?
Second position.
At second position. Right. 2, which one this one?
Chloro.
2 chloro. Okay now?
Yes.
And how many carbon atoms are there?
3.
This prefix over. After the prefix, root bond. Root bond. How many carbons? 3 carbons.
Pro.
Any double bond is there?
No.
Ane. And COOH group is there. What we use? Oic acid.
Propanoic acid.
2 chloro propanoic acid. The IUPAC name of that molecule is 2 chloro propanoic acid. Okay, for example, CH3COOH. Okay, here also, CH3 also, prefix. These two prefixes. Right, neither the neighboring from functional group. 1, 2, 3, okay, how many prefixes are there?
Two prefixes.
Same prefix or different prefix?
Same
prefix. Okay, right, first position of that one. Okay, first position of that one. 2 here, comma. At third position also, we have methyl. Second position, we have methyl. At third position also, we have methyl. 2, comma, 3. Dimethyl. 2 present means, 2 same present means, we use methyl 2,3-dimethyl. Here how many carbon atoms are there? 4 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. Butyl. Ane. Oic. Okay. 2,3-dimethyl butanoic acid. Okay. In continuation, we will see the some more molecules next class. Next class I will give you some examples. You have to practice. Before that, you should read what is root word, okay, and what is prefix, what is primary suffix, what is secondary suffix, along with the groups and their names. For example, OH group is there, we use OL, OL. Okay, COOH group is there, we use OIC acid. Use like that. Okay, you should know about that. Otherwise, okay, it will become ambiguity, complexity. You never get this. You remember that principle. After that only will get. So, read all these rules and all those. After that only we'll do the problems. That means we'll write the names of anorganic molecule. Okay, tomorrow I'll send one copy to in copying group. Write all those molecules. Thank you.